Lois was telling me how she had a hard time getting used to cleaning everything up. In the center, others took care of it. We both had to learn that it's not like mopping the kitchen floor. The cycler has to be cleaned after every treatment, even if we can't see any dirt on it. Lois has a few minutes remaining in her treatment. As she gets ready to end treatment, her first step is to check the amount of saline remaining in the bag. She checks that there is 300 to 500 milliliters of saline left in the saline bag. She sees the 000 in the caution bar with her dialysate and ultrafiltration rates at zero. Since her treatment has finished, she simply presses stop to stop the blood pump and see the rinse back volume displayed. Lois puts on her gloves now, and her next step is to disconnect her arterial patient line from her vascular access. She starts by clamping the arterial vascular access line in the arterial patient line. She places one of the syringes from the saline spike on the arterial needle line. Now she connects the arterial patient line to the priming spike and unclamps the line. Next, she completes rinse back by pressing add fluid on the cycler. When the cycler counts down to zero, she double checks her lines to make sure they're clear of blood. She knows that it's okay if her lines are tinged pink slightly, as it represents a very small amount of blood. She takes her blood pressure and pulse rate and records them. Lois can now clamp her venous patient line and disconnect it from her venous vascular access. She connects the venous patient line to the priming spike. She removes the fistula needles from her access site one at a time and cares for her access site. She also needs to make sure any sharps, like needles, are properly disposed of following her dialysis center's guidelines. She takes a moment to press volume toggle and write down her treatment information. She notes her treatment time, dialysate delivered, ultrafiltration removed, and blood liters processed. Lois takes a moment to take her standing weight and blood pressure. She records them on her post-treatment assessment. With all of her lines disconnected, she can safely turn off the cycler and turn off her warmer by putting it in standby. She presses the down arrow until the standby indicator lights are lit. Then she disconnects the power cord from the cycler to the warmer. With everything off, she can dispose of used supplies like the cartridges, the gloves, and the empty dialysate bags. Lois cannot remove the bag from the warmer until the hot surface light is off to prevent possible burns. Finally, she cleans the outside of the cycler and warmer. She makes sure the cycler door is closed, then uses a paper towel and a mild detergent to clean the cycler and warmer. She makes sure that none of the liquid gets inside the cycler as she cleans. Oh, it looks like there's a little blood on the cycler. Lois makes a bleach solution to clean blood from the equipment. The solution is a mixture of one part bleach to 100 parts water. To make the solution, she uses 1 tablespoon of bleach with 1 quart of water. She wipes down the cycler with the bleach solution, letting it sit on the cycler for 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, Lois again wipes down the cycler with the bleach solution and lets it sit on the cycler for another 10 minutes. Then, using a clean paper towel and tap water, she rinses off the bleach solution and allows the cycler to air dry. When she's done, Lois throws away her bleach solution and other cleaning supplies. Now her cycler is ready for her next treatment.